In today's video, I'm going to transform into Venom.
In this world, it's carnage.
And also, if you want to win an electric skateboard that goes super fast and takes long distance, keep watching. I'm going to transform myself into Venom, and this is basically inspired from the latest trailer for the second Venom movie. We can see this awesome transformation, and it's totally got me intrigued on how to achieve it. So in today's video, we'll see how I've done that. We will need a 3D character from Venom that is animated. We will need to record ourselves against a green screen or on the location we want the thing to actually happen at. And then we need a bunch of effects to turn ourselves into Venom. So we'll see how to do all of that in this video. So the first thing I've done is looked online for reference on Venom. So I found this model from Venom, but unfortunately the way it was exported or modeled didn't allow me for a very efficient workflow. So I basically had to completely redo it in order to achieve a good result. So here are the things you would need to do if you wanted to animate a 3D character. When you have your model, you also need to rig it in order to animate it. So it's basically putting a skeleton inside the body of your model so you can animate it later on. But that's not enough. You will also need to weight your model, so actually telling the bones where to bend at and where not. And if this all is not complicated enough, you will also need to animate everything yourself by hand or using a motion capture suit. And trust me, hand animation can take a lot of time, and especially a lot of skill is required because you need to nail the exact timings of real animation. So really study how something moves. I'm going to be honest, in this video, I did a really quick animation job. I didn't really think it through, but I still think the result looks totally awesome. And that's just for the animation. Now you also need a texture, and for a texture, you basically need to unstitch your entire 3D model in order to paint on top of it. So it doesn't automatically recognize where you want to apply things. It's 2021, but still, it cannot figure out how to do that. So we need to do UV unwrapping, and that's also a big hassle. So doing all of these things combined can really require some work, but once you get a hang of it, you can do so many fun things. So that was basically the experiment on my part, to just do everything from A to Z on how to make a character, on how to rig it, how to weight it, and how to texture it. So that was a really awesome experience. So now that I have my Venom 3D character, it's time to move into the green screen room. I know it's a little bit messy around here, so I gotta clean it up and set up everything to record myself against a green screen. I'm going to light the green screen evenly with two tube lights from Kane TV, and I have a one key light right here that is facing 45 degrees angle to me. I know the lighting isn't going to be super solid, and that's just because I have a little bit of a lack of space. I would also need a rim light behind me to make it a lot more interesting, but that's going to be for our next one. I'm also going to be recording here with the Panasonic S1H. And I've set this up with the small rig cage, which is really awesome and makes it a lot more comfortable to use as a cinema camera. And I'm also using the Atomos Ninja 5, which is connected to the S1H, and this allows you to capture a lot more data in ProRes RAW, which is just insane, and that's going to help me a ton with keying. So I will have a lot of color data. And also in general, when you're recording, the Panasonic S1H is a very worthy cinema camera, so I have a lot more dynamic range and a lot more color to play with. I definitely want to dive in that more. So yeah, let's record. Alright, so now that we have our footage, we can start anticipating on what kind of animation we want to add to our 3D Venom model. So the first thing that I've done is making sure that Venom looks in the kind of same spot that I am when I'm recording on the green screen. So I also lower the position of Venom because Venom is I think around 2 meters and 70 centimeters. Not sure how much that is in feet, but that's a whole lot taller than me. So I bended him down so he is around my size. And then I also animated him to grow and move up and actually overpower the scene. So I animated my 3D Venom. Then I optimized my scene to render it with Octane Render Engine. I exported everything into Adobe After Effects. And now I'm left with my original footage and my Venom animation. So MEEPO sent over this V4 for me to enjoy riding these electric longboards. It feels like I'm surfing on the street. It's just such a free feeling. The only thing that you have to be cautious with is that you're very safe while doing so, because if you're not present in the moment, it can be dangerous. So if you end up winning this one, make sure that you wear a helmet so you can continue watching my videos. Alright, so what do you actually have to do in order to win? So the first thing that you will need to do is just download my Venom animation with the link in the description below. And what I want you to do with that is completely up to you. I want you to either create a video or a photo where you're using my Venom 3D model. And you don't even have to be good. The most important thing is that it's creative and it has a proof of concept. So whatever our team thinks has the best proof of concept will actually win the board. So it's a really fun experiment. Your chances of winning are super high, so I would definitely try it out. So download Venom with the link in the description. And then the second thing you would have to do is follow me on Instagram and post your results there. Make sure that you tag me in your results. It can either be a story or a post or a reel. It's completely up to you. Be creative with it. Just use the Venom and actually follow me on Instagram and tag me. So it's completely up to you. Be creative with it and let the best win. I'm really looking forward to making someone happy with a MEEPO V4. So then you can feel exactly what I'm feeling when I go on a ride after a long day of work. Alright, so back to the video. I have myself here on the green screen. So I will key myself out, and now I'm going to try the moment when I want the transformation to start. I will make a marker here, and then around a second later, I'm going to make another marker. I want my transformation to last around maximum 1 second. And basically what I have used to create all of this is using the Puppet Warp tool and the Liquify tool. These two tools are super powerful when you want to do morphing in Adobe After Effects. This will make keyframes for that mesh on that position, and then I just tried to match either myself and Venom for that entire second, so the transformation would actually look genuine and actually look like he is transforming from myself. After that, I want the Venom body to grow on myself, so I'm going to use my own footage as an alpha mat, and I'm going to create a fractal noise layer, which I'm going to animate from black to white. Which means that everything that is black will be invisible, everything that is white will become visible, and fractal noise gives you that organic look. After that, I use the Liquify tool to make it look like the teeth are actually warping my skin around and displacing it in that position. So when something is actually peeking through your skin, the other skin around it is going to move away. So that's what I'm trying to replicate here with the Liquify tool. Then I also use the duplicate of this layer, also with the Liquify tool, to get these streaks here. And for these streaks, there is actually a great tutorial that you can follow on Video Copilot, which was about Harry Potter, but it's basically that effect that I applied here to get that smear look to have the transformation effect from Venom. So you can use this effect in a ton of creative ways. So now I have something like this, and this already looks super dope, but it doesn't look quite real just yet. So I'm going to pre-compose everything together and apply RSMB on that. That's a plugin that fakes the motion blur, but it makes everything blend a lot smoother in the animation. After that, I wanted to bring a little bit more life to my Venom and add some details that would normally be very hard to achieve in 3D. So again, from Video Copilot, you can download this slime pack that they make available for free, and it's really awesome to use in a scene, for example, like this. When Venom opens his mouth, I want the slime to actually drip from his teeth, and that just looks disgusting and juicy, and that looks exactly like Venom. So what I have done is I added the slime to my scene, and I also used the Puppet Warp tool in order to make it follow the teeth and actually stretch along with the mouth. That's a really creative way to use the Puppet Warp tool, so you can use this again in a bunch of creative ways. All I want to achieve with this video is for you to realize what you can do with these tools, research them on your own, and maybe you can come up with some really creative stuff. I would love to see what you can create. Also, you can tag me for that on Instagram. I always pre-compose once my Puppet Warp tool is done, just so I bake the footage in itself, and then I mask out the part around his mouth so it looks like it's just happening in the mouth. So now I have the final result of Venom, just without a background. We will need a background. After that, you have to crappetize your footage, a really important step when it comes to VFX. That's applying everything that a camera usually has to your 3D model, such as noise, displacements, chromatic aberrations, stuff like that, just to make everything blend in together. So I made everything blend together, and now I have my final result. But before I show that, we also have to apply some sound effects, which is also really important for all the juiciness that Venom has. So you will need a good audio installation to hear those sounds crystal clear. And I just wanted to thank Adam Audio one more time, because they actually sent over the Adam Audio monitors a whole while back, but I've been enjoying them for so long now. And it really changes the game when it comes to sound effects. I really hear all the sound layering in music, and it's a whole different experience listening to music. So I did my sound effects for Venom, and also a good technique to apply once in a while is to listen on different audio devices, try it with a headset and see how that works, because your audience is going to have different experiences, and for some things it's really important to hear different details. And for that, I'm actually using the Meze Audio headset here, which is really sleek from design. I really enjoy it, and it also has really clear audio, and it sits super comfortable on my ears. It's over ears, and they just feel super snug, and they're maybe the most comfortable headsets that I have worn for a longer period of time. Anyway, now that we have super awesome sound effects, it's time to watch our final result. Here it is.
I don't feel so good.
Alright, so I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. And I will leave you with another video of mine, because they're pretty cool and maybe you want to check out another one. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.